my biggest issue was like not letting people give me money for things I do, and so I finally just like gave people the option to support me, because I was pretty much donating all of my time and effort and the bots and the Google Cloud instance that I run. So yeah.
Well, at the end of the day, content creation is work, so yeah. It makes sense.
We appreciate everything you do too, Logan.
Thanks.
Really. All right, Anton, where can we
find you? Go next. I'm Anton. I'm All Hate Borders basically everywhere. As for content, I have produced, besides being active on Twitter and yelling at people, I have written a blog on Commander Social Aspects, which is called Collective Voyage. I'm going to link it in chat. And I also got the opportunity to write an article for the Commander Rules Committee website for the New Voices section on power dynamics in Commander. So you can check that out if you're interested in my writing. And you can look at my decks on my Twitter. They are linked in my bio. The blog's linked there as well. And if there are any discussions coming up on Twitter, I'm usually participating. So feel free to add me and tell me why I'm wrong. So
the hottest takes.
Tomer.
Hello. My name is Tomer, and I'm a contributor to MTG Goldfish. And I write a budget commander series where I try to make the most powerful decks at the lowest budget points. And I also host a weekly series called Commander Clash, where a bunch of the Goldfish crew plays Commander on Magic Online. And there's a lot of punts, and there's a lot of petty rivalries. And it's not optimal Magic. I don't think anybody who's looking for good pro play should ever watch it. That would be a terrible choice. But if you just like pettiness and watching me punt and other people punt, then it's a good time.
I still haven't watched this week's episode, so I'm looking forward to it.
Trust me, there's a lot of punts there. Yeah, that's it for me. So, we all have our starting hand. I'm eager to see what is in store for this one. And I think, Joe, you're going first, right?
That is correct. Are we ready? We good?
Yeah,
I'm ready.
All right, let us begin. Draw a card. Oh my goodness, this is kind of bad. But I think it's still good.
So good.
So glad that you got Jairuda for this deck, Toma.
It was like made for me.
I want to play Cavern of Souls, everybody's favorite tribal land, and I'm going to name humans as the type. And then I will pass the turn.
Not Brushwag?
Not Brushwag, no.
Power Lodge.
I'm assuming it's just going clockwise, like on the...
Correct, on the screen.
Yes.
Awesome. The way you see it.
I'm going to draw a card. And then I'm going to play a myriad landscaped tap, and I'll pass a turn.
It's not a bad one.
A little bit of ramp.
I'm going to play a tapped land, too. I'm going to play a tapped Bad River.
Love tapped land. Ahead, Logan.
I'm going to play a Godless Shrine tapped and pass.
Man, everybody playing these tap lands turn one is so good.
Fast start, everyone.
It's the best start. So I'm going to play Blighted Woodland. Oh my gosh, this hurts. I'm going to tap for two to play a Talisman of Impulse, and then I'm going to deal myself one damage for a green and play a Birds of Paradise. It hurts so good, though.
How to ramp with colorless mana.
I didn't draw my Avacyn's Pilgrim opening hand, so it's kind of feels bad. But yeah, that's my turn.
Yeah, untap. Oh, this is my first webcam game, by the way, and I don't play much paper, so I'm going to be terrible, and I'm going to miss a lot of things.
I hate to tell you, Tomer, but if you're expecting pity, you can take that somewhere else.
I know. Just like if you think, I play floodplains tapped, and I pass a turn. If you think I punt a lot
aggressively, I'm going to draw my card. Oh, that's a sweet new card. I want to play that. I'm going to play a Draenor Temple and pass.
All this colorless mana.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Feels so
goodness
good.
Just because crazy. I can, I'm going to do stuff on Logan's upkeep. I'm going to crack this Bad River, find a swamp and then cycle my Twisted Abomination to find a swamp.
Sure.
So I'm going to do this now too, actually. I'm going to, in response, tap Muriel Landscape for colorless, and then basic lane cycle Ash Barrens. I'm going to take a very long time to do this, so go ahead.
I'm going to play this forest, and I'm going to pass turn. Just to expedite things, I'm going to entomb on the end of Anton's turn.
Okay. Why can everybody being so nice, doing stuff to expedite things? I'm going to play a Plains.
I think it was only like a week ago that I learned that these land cyclers can actually find non-basics.
Yeah, they can find duels.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yep. I love those.
But I drew my duels, so I'm just going to find a normal swamp. Put it in my hand.
Alright, so I'm going to tap for a green, colorless, and we'll go red for a human spell and a white. And I'm going to cast Girid, Conclave Exile.
Ooh.
Imagine not playing land cyclers in your deck.
What's that?
Imagine not playing land cyclers in your deck. All these people are playing good cards.
I mean,
that's just how the draw came out, to be honest with you. I expect to play this off of a Wynota trigger, not just all of a sudden.
I mean, it's not bad. It's power.
You get a rhino, yeah?
Yeah, that's what I'm looking for right now in my mountain of tokens that I swear I was prepared for.
That was the commander deck where you got one rhino for your commander that basically always makes at least two, right?
Yes. When he enters the battlefield, I create a 4/4 green rhino token with trample. Whenever he attacks, I populate the token, enters the battlefield tapped and attacking. So I can choose to do something else. And I will actually pass the turn to Tomer.
All right, I will untap. I will play a swamp. And now what I'm going to do is going to be very, very shuffle intensive. I'm going to crack the floodplain for an overgrown tomb? No, I'm going to crack it for a watery grave. And then I'm going to use untap. So I'm going to take 2 damage. And I'm going to use that 2 mana to crack the myriad landscape for 2 forests. I just want to do that all at once to save a lot of time. So
the value.
This will be cracked for water grave. This will be for 2 forests. I lose 2 life. Ding, ding.
Ding, ding.
Ramp is cheating.
And then I pass the turn. So there's a watery grave.
Untap. So how am I going to play around Logan entombing end of turn? Okay, I'm just kidding. So I'm going to play a swamp.
Did you entomb? Sorry, Logan. Sorry.
I was waiting to announce it till end of turn, but I'll just show it now. It's a Zatalpa Primal Dawn.
Okay, and that's at the end of Anton's turn.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what? I'm not going to play the swamp. I'm going to mountain cycle the Igneous Pouncer and play a mountain. It's much better. And then I'm going to pass.
Right. Entomb happens.
Oh, that was so fast. Talpa
is a good one.
Play a Nesting Grounds. And let's play this.
Shout out to the Dino Mom herself.
Faberow Elder.
Blessed Day.
Such a good card.
It's Bloom Tender Light. and then I will pass turn.
Is it Bloom Tender Light, though?
It's a beefy Bloom Tender.
It's beef tender.
Yeah, let's do that. It's
a beef steroid. Tender.
I like that. I like that a lot.
I like Beef Tender a lot, yeah.
Beef Tender sounds like a questionable name from it.
Beef Tender.
Alright, since everybody likes to do so much tutoring, I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. So I'm going to pay 4 using the Birds of Paradise to produce the green for Blighted Woodland, and I'm going to bring a Forest and a Mountain basic into play tapped. Since everybody's doing so much ramping. And then I'm going to play a Smoldering Marsh that is going to come into play untapped since I control two basics. And then I'm going to swing out. And I think I'm going to try to split this up as much as I can. So here's the Smoldering Marsh. The Rhino is going to go at Logan, and the Gyrid is going to go at Tomer. And then the other Rhino is going to be tapped and attacking against Anton.
No blocks.
How much damage is Dara?
It's two.
Okay. Take two.
Two, four, and four. Grab that other Rhino token. All right. And then I will pass the turn.
Sweet.
Get a little tap. Aggressive. Getting a little too aggressive.
Okay.
For everyone watching, I'm sorry. It seems like my camera is coming off way worse on stream than it is on spell table for us, but I hope it's fine.
Yeah, looks okay.
Yeah. I think it's fine in here. I don't know about the stream. Yeah, it looks about the same.
Okay. I'm going to tap two. Cycle Rampaging Hippo. Draw a card.
Oh, Shark Typhoon is a six drop.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, and it is. Can cycle.
Yeah, can.
I'm so hyped.
And then I'm going to play a land and then pay three to put Garuda into my hand. I believe that's how it works with Companion now.
Yes, sir.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, seven cards in hand, and I pass the turn.
Speaking of Shark Typhoon, I got the Shark Wave tokens from Aaron Miller.
Nice. They're so good.
That's Rocket Sharks. Yeah. They're so cool.
So, Tomer's deck reminds me of the you just wait till your father gets home. Because it's like he doesn't do anything until turn six. So it's, you know, quiet and unassuming. But he's like, oh, you wait. You just wait till I get that six mana.
I mean, I have a bunch of six drops. So, you know, there's something going to be big coming.
I'm going to pay four to cast this Tree of Petition here.
Ooh.
That's a scary tree.
That is actually very scary.
Interesting.
Maybe you shouldn't antagonize me with your rhinos next turn.
Or maybe I should.
Go ahead, Logan.
All right.
Maybe you should.
Draw. Huh.
That Kefril has too many keywords already.
Yeah, there's five. I keep track of it on this handy Infinitoken.
Shout out to Infinitoken.
Yeah, I really need to pick up some blanks from them.
I'm going to tap for three black over here for a Leyline Prowler. Shout out to this little keyword mana dork buddy.
That's so good. Death Touch and Lifelink? Yes, please. Mm-hmm.
Then I will tap the Faber Elder for three and play this Ronus the Indomitable.
Ooh.
And then I will.
One of my favorite parts in deck building, by the way, figuring out ways to like do the basics, like removal, ramp, and card draw. In a way that fits your deck better than usual staples. Like Logan's mana dogs, they all give keywords to his commander. It's just like sweet when you find these cards that are maybe not the best at raid what they're doing, but they are much better in your deck.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I guess better with synergy.
Yeah, Death Touch Lifelink for three mana.
Mm-hmm.
Seems
and it's like, oh man, if it dies early, whoop-de-doo, now I got two keywords in my graveyard.
I mean, I guess it's time for me to cast one of my commanders, wouldn't y'all say? Oh.
Time for the beatdown.
Let's go with Bruise. The Hefty. Herder. And we're going to target Gyrid with the Double Strike and Lifelink.
Sure. Rayan actually got nerfed with the new death trigger rule, right? Because now when Rayan goes to exile, you don't get to distribute counters.
It's, No. So Rayhan's wording is actually prevents that. It says whenever a creature you control dies or is put into the command zone, if it had one or more counters on it, you put that many plus one counters on target creature. So it has its own little nice clause.
But if you go to exile, then you change zones again, so you don't have counters, right?
Right. It was a weird loophole with you flicker it and you choose command zone and then it comes back.
So that trick doesn't work anymore?
Right. Because it actually just gets exiled and then put into the command zone. So changes zones, can't come back.
Yeah, that's only on exile though, right?
Yeah.
That's not so it gets the dice triggers.
Right.
Let's go to combat. Tomer, you are taking 4 damage from Geared.
Okay.
Anton, I'm going to attack you with Rhino, and then the other populated Rhino is going to be attacking you as well. So that's 2 Rhinos coming at you.
That's fair. I can just block one.
Yeah. And then, Logan, you are getting the other Rhino.
Okay.
I'm going to block one Rhino.
I will actually block that Rhino with my Leyline Prowler.
Seems good. Take 1 damage. So then let's just get rid of this extra.
They have trample?
It has trample, yep.
Yeah, I have lifelink, death touch.
Okay. Oh, that's right. So you're going to be
actually gaining one, right?
Yeah. Yep.
And that goes there. Now I have 2 more keywords.
Block with my face. I'll take 4.
There's that 6 mana, though. I'm kind of concerned about that.
I only have 5.
Well, I mean, next turn.
Hopefully.
All right. So after damage, a second main phase, I'm going to go for 1 red, 1 and another red, and I'm going to cast an axe, Hardened in the Forge.
Yeah.
Because I need to be able to make some Satyr tokens.
I put an axe in my Timuret red-black, like, it's a shared pain kind of deck. And... Mm. It's a little bit like Aristocrats style. And then when it actually hit me that he makes 2 tokens if the creature's big enough,
yep.
I was like, whoa.
Yeah, it's pretty powerful.
this is amazing. Powerful card.
All right, and then I'm going to pass turn.
Yeah. On tap. Hope that
is
I hit.
Is NX also human, or is it just a demigod?
No, it's a demigod, so it works with It works with Wynota.
Ooh. And you make Satyrs.
Mm-hmm.
The value.
Vinoda is such a stupid card, by the way.
It really is.
The worst thing is that the things that enter get an indestructibility, where you can't even make profitable blocks, just like, well, you take some damage here. Cool.
So, I'm going to exile 2 cards to delve with Tassiger. I'm going to throw them over here.
My cat keeps trying to climb on my lap, and then she's very picky about how she sits on my lap, so she just keeps screaming at me.
Mine does that same thing whenever I'm streaming at night.
I'm going to crack Evolving Wilds for an island, and I will pass a turn.
Untap. The tree is active.
Ruh-roh, Raggy.
I just want to... That's not what I wanted to draw. I had something in mind, but not this. I'm going to play a Smoldering Marsh. Just gonna enter untapped because I have 2 basics. How threatening do I want to look here?
I mean, you can turn somebody's life total into 13.
Could put my companion in my hand and play a 2-drop. Then my next turn's not that fun. I guess I'm just gonna pay 2 to cast this Leaden Muir. Get some ramp going. And I think I'm still just gonna use the special action to put Umori into my hand.
Cool.
And I'm not gonna attack, so I will pass to Logan.
Untap.
So wait, Anton, you're not gonna attack with your defender?
I think I am not allowed to.
Mm-hmm. Let's see.
I think no one really wants this tree attacking them. Like, it would be pretty scary to have the tree with all the bodies hanging from it coming at you, swinging.
I mean, I prefer the tree running at me than it tapping and reducing my life total to 13.
Let's see. How do I want to do this? I feel like I need to ramp a little more.
We only have 3 lands.
Yeah. I've missed 2 land drops, I think. Because I haven't gotten one this turn. I'm going to Demonic Tutor.
Ooh. Seems good. For a land?
for something.
the pro play.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
I mean, let's be honest. Like, nobody hasn't Demonic Tutored for a land before.
We're actually going to Demonic Tutor for...
I have never Demonic Tutored, so...
Oh. Ooh.
Oh, when you do, you're gonna tutor for a land first time.
Yeah,
and then I'm gonna just cast what I find, which is this.
I mean,
beautiful cultivate.
Decks play a ton of lands.
So with cultivate, I will find a plains and a swamp. We'll do plains into hand, swamp into play tapped.
Are those basics the foil ones from Ikoria?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'll play the planes for turn. And then I will be done.
Leaving that planes open for a path to exile, I see how it is.
I mean, if you're not posturing, what are you doing?
Yeah, there's always a chance.
Like last night, I'm playing this budget elf ball deck, and I posture by leaving 1 green open for a fog. There's no fog in the deck.
So I've actually had many. We've had, and it's actually been on stream twice. We've had fog save the day. We've had the black fog, darkest day, and as well as the regular fog save the day.
That cultivate's awesome.
Yeah, I love that thing. All right, so I drew my card.
Very pretty.
And
I played a...
I haven't played a land yet.
Played a fun game on Saturday noonish, where I kept Sunforgering for Dawn Charm to fog lethal commander damage from the other Boros player, but then I got by Chance for Glory of their Sunforger. Mm-hmm. That was sweet.
Man, I don't want to set myself up for a board wipe here, but... What are you doing if you're not going for it, am I right?
Exactly.
The White Nota time?
I wish. So I put 4 tutors in here, and I can't seem to draw a single one of them. Paradise Druid, which has Hexproof if it's untapped.
Very nice.
I bet that's in Logan's deck as well.
Well, it doesn't actually...
Paradise Druid? Actually, no.
Yeah, it doesn't, because it doesn't actually
have Hexproof in your graveyard.
As the keyword, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, there some of those, like, I wish I could. It's like there's some that like gain menace when they attack or whatever, or gain something when they attack.
So I'm actually going to take it easy on Anton, and I'm going to declare attacks with Bruise to him. And then I'm going to attack, I guess I'll attack all out on. Well, we'll do 1 Rhino at Tomer and gear it at Tomer, and then. Mm-hmm. The double striking lifelink rhino at Logan, and another non double strike lifelinking rhino at Logan.
Well, I take 12.
So Gyrid's a 2/5?
Yeah, it's a 2/5.
And the rhino is a 4/4?
It's a 4/4, yeah.
Okay, I'll block the Rhino with Tassiger, which is a 4/5. And I'll take 2.
I'm going to block your Brewstar with my tree.
Okay. And I will gain 8.
I'm in a bit of a pickle here. Like, I feel good about you not attacking me, but now that the other players are taking so much damage, not that much value to tree them. And you have 51 life. That would be a really thick tree.
Yeah.
Very thick tree.
Which is why I'm kind of banking on...
And you have life linkers on board. So
yeah, like, that's the thing.
Do you even mind going to 13 that much?
No, like...
Do you even mind?
I love how nice you are. Thank you so much for hearing my considering my feelings in that. Yeah. No. I mean, by all means.
Okay, that's good.
By all means.
So you'll gain back.
Yes.
I mean, it's always best if you keep hurting people and then say, "Well, it's fine. I appreciate that."
I mean, I did just do 12 damage to somebody else, so you doming me for 37 just doesn't seem that bad.
Your call.
Second main
I
phase.
I take that as a win.
Man, should I do this right now? Or do I just wait for it? Wait for it?
I should in before I get got by Teferi's protection. Just peace out, there's no next one.
That would be the ultimate get got moment.
I can't do this right now. I'm just going to pass her.
Is Carson in chat?
Yeah. I will untap, draw a card. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to try and deal with the board now. 2, 4, 6 to cast Deadly Tempest. Destroy all creatures. Each player loses life equal to the number of creatures they controlled that were destroyed this way.
All right.
So now I have to figure what I want to do with my tree.
Yeah.
So random variety.
How many creatures do you have, Joe?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that 13 is going to turn into 6.
Oof.
That would be brutal.
What are the other options? I could just set Choma to 13.
Mm-hmm.
That would be appropriate.
But if I do nothing, then Joe just stays at 46 something.
I stay there.
I mean, I think I just need to target you. It's just okay. The only right thing to do.
So, down to 13.
Okay.
Okay, I lose 1.
I lose 2. Any other responses?
No.
Okay, so that resolves. I'll put Tassiger back into my command zone. We'll lose 1 life.
I've got NX triggers, so I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and one of those creatures has a power. I'm sorry. Yeah, NX has the power of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm gonna gain 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tokens. Satyr 1/1 tokens that can't block.
Yep.
And then I'm going to just drop a lonely sandbar tapped, and I'm going to pass it to her.
Oh, look at what that sandbar. So lonely.
Yeah. Usually I cycle them. I have 46 lands in the deck, but not finding them easily this game. So there's probably a big land pocket somewhere in my deck.
So unfortunately, Theros never granted me the 1/1 Satyr tokens, so I'm going to have to improvise here. And I don't have infinite tokens. I'm sorry.
I'm gonna
share mine if I could.
Have a sweet value play here. I'm gonna pay for to cast my companion.
Look at these two shiny boys.
And to no one's surprise, I will say creature. And because my creatures cost 1 less, I will cast this Milliken for 1.
Nice.
And I too didn't draw a land so far. So I'm gonna
mill me. Ooh.
I can't mill other players.
Oh, that sucks. All right, you're done?
Oh yeah, I'm done, sorry.
I swear I had some goblin tokens around here.
Oh, I just realized how miserable casting Garuda will be. How do I steal your creatures on a webcam?
Imagine having infinite tokens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's fine. You just infinite tokens.
Maybe I have to pick some up.
This seems like an opportunity.
It's not legal in your colors.
Do something.
Nah, I get that. The blue sorcery. Blue instant.
I'm going to cast Jared's Orders. Search for two creatures, reveal them. One goes into hand, the other into my graveyard.
I love that card. I actually have it. I think I have it in... Oh, yeah, it's in this deck.
Let's go. One of the best cards in Kithril.
So there's the 5 cost that does the same thing.
Final Parting, right?
Yeah, and I'm like, it's an instant, I think. There's also
but it gets any card, not just creatures.
Yeah, not just creatures. Cards. So I'm always battling between like Final Parting and Jared's Orders. But I always go for like the mana play on that.
Yeah. Question is, what do I want to put in there?
I was so sad when the new Purphoros had 7 power because I wanted to get another haste anthem on a creature in this deck. But I only go up to 6 power on Granzo, so 7 power doesn't make the cut. Currently I'm running the 3 mana goblin that says all my creatures have haste and attack each turn if able, but I want to replace that one.
I think that we're going to put... We are going to get Sunblade Angel. And I think we're going to get our good old friend, Carny T.
Carny T. Very nice. Oh my gosh. Hexproof?
Hexproof. Yep. We're going to put the Carny T in the graveyard. Sunblade into hand. And then I will pass.
Which is Sunblade Angel?
Sunblade Angel is like, it's like mini Achroma. It's a 6 mana flying first strike lifelink Vigi. So 4 keywords. It's a 3/3. From War of the Spark.
Yeah.
That's going to be very difficult to kill Cthrill then. So hexproof and indestructible.
Yeah.
And double strike.
That will be my turn.
I mean, are you missing any of the good keywords so far? Flying, double strike, vigilance, trample.
He's not missing
death touch, I think.
Sounds like he's got all of them at this point. Yeah.
I need reach and menace and first strike, and then I'll have them all.
Gotta catch them all.
And then when I have all 11 in my graveyard, I win the game, right?
That's exactly how
that Yeah.
If that's the case, we need to kill you or exile your graveyard sooner rather than later.
One white, red, and 2.
All right,
and then one more for Bruise. Going to target one of the satyrs because I need to gain some life. I don't know if you heard.
I'm not going to block any of your satyrs if you swing at me.
Oh, that would be so petty to go after you.
I mean, I feel it's more like deserved than petty.
No, it's fine. We'll go 2 lifelinking damage at Tomer plus, I guess we'll do 2, 3, 4.
Look at that.
No, we'll just do 3.
Turned on the card module.
3 damage for me?
It'll be 4 total damage, 3 creatures going at you.
Okay.
And then for Logan, it's going to be 3 as well. 3 damage. Oh, wow. 3 creatures, I believe, yeah, because that's 6. Yep. All right. I'm just gonna gain my measly two.
You're getting back. Getting back to the double digits soon.
And then I'm going to end the turn there. To six.
Untap. Draw a card. Oh boy. I really don't want to cast Garuda. It seems really good, but not with zero ways of actually tracking opponent creatures. So instead,
if you got scratch paper, that works too.
Yeah,
I'm going to do that probably next turn cycle. But for now, I'm going to just pay 2, 4, 6. Anton, we're friends. I'm going to cast Sphinx of Enlightenment. And when it enters the battlefield, target opponent draws a card, and you draw 3 cards. So Anton, you will be my target opponent who draws a card if this resolves. All right, I assume it resolves.
Yeah.
Yep. All right, I'm going to draw 3.
So just one of my favorite commander cards.
Okay.
Some stuff.
I'll play my favorite land of all time.
Oh, I guess I need to have my deck list ready too. Sorry about that.
Temple of the False God.
I posted it here last night.
Where's Benny?
I mean, I'm basically exactly on Benny's side. Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Friendship with Toma has ended. Logan is new friend. No, you're good. Your deck is like one of these decks. Like, you will always make your land drops because you can't cast any of your spells if you don't. So Temper is like never a liability.
46 lands is important in this deck.
And Ramping is so good for you because you want to get that turn ahead.
And then I think so. Tasker's 7, so 3. I could cast, but then I would exile my entire library. So no. Then I'm just going to pass the turn.
Okie dokes. Untap, upkeep, draw a land, please. Deck.
Look for scratch paper.
That's not a land card. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 yeah, mana.
You and me, we're kind of stuck on that 5 land life.
I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Yeah, I'm playing like 40 lands, so I should draw one. Now if I make mana with my Milliken, I will mill a land for sure. That's how it works, right?
That's exactly how it works.
So I can play a 7 drop, or I can play like 2, 4 drops. Cost reduction is so good. I only have 2 red mana, so I can't play 2 red spells. Yeah. If anything that helps me get a land in the future, not really. I'll just start by making a mana with my Milliken to see what's up. I'm gonna mill a swamp.
Well, thank you, Infinite Tokens. I appreciate that myself. And I may actually just go ordering right after this game.
Yeah, thanks a lot. It's from the Etsy store, right? Or where did you order your Infinity Tokens, Logan?
Yeah, they've got an Etsy store.
Okay, for my next trick, I'm gonna pay 2.
Yep, would you mill off of the Milliken, Anton?
I milled the swamp, as I said.
As predicted.
The land. I'm gonna cast Gonti. It's like a bit awkward on webcam, but I think Gonti is fine because it's just hot. One card. And right, Gonti is one of my favorite EDH designs. Just does all the things I want to do.
Yeah.
I don't think I want a 6 drop though, so I think I'm gonna target Logan.
Oh, this is gonna be interesting.
Seems real good. Logan, you can DM him a picture of your top 4.
Yeah, like.
Oh, are you doing that?
We could also show it to the stream, so if you
two. I was replying to somebody, so I didn't know
that
you chose me.
People can see what's up there as well. Right.
So how do you want to do this?
Why don't we find people in chat see what I got, right? So if you show to the camera while Toma and Joe look away, that's probably best, right?
Yeah, right. I'll look away.
I'll just tell you which card. Then
I will look away as well, and you can just tell me left to right.
Oh, I want the second one from the left.
This one?
This one. And I have one lying around.
Okay.
I can grab it later. That's great. That's a good pick. These go on the bottom? They go on the bottom in random order.
Okay.
So...
No peeking, Tomer.
You're good to look now.
We're good? Yeah. All right.
Because we were totally trustworthy and honest, I didn't see that.
And I can't cast that card now, because it's more expensive than what I have left here. So I'm going to pay 2 mana to cast Felden of the Third Path.
Seems real good.
And I think I want to attack with Umori. How big is the swing, Stoma?
It's a 5/5.
Well, that's huge. And I think I'm just going to hit Logan for 4. He can't block currently.
Does anybody have graveyard hate? Just asking out loud.
Asking for a friend.
I'm looking for my Bajuka bug. I could not find it.
I'm done after that.
Well, you missed your opportunity because I think I'm going to cast my commander now.
Yeah.
I wanted to wait, but I just got hit again. So, I need to get my life back.
I just now realized you're at 17.
Yeah. So, I'm going to cast Cathedral, Aspect Warper.
Woof.
We've got Flying, Death Strike, Vigilance, Trample, Indestructible, Death Touch, Lifelink, Hexproof.
Not bad.
That's why I just hit you, because now I can't hit you anymore.
We're just going to put all those counters right on Cathedral. So, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, he gets 8 counters. It's 11-11.
That's the
now...
bad number. 11 double strike.
So it's 11-11 double strike trample?
11-11 double strike trample, Vigi, lifelink, indestructible, hexproof, flying.
Flying.
Yeah. All that. That's a one shot.
And then I'll just pass the turn there.
Interesting.
I mean, I was really trying to hold out until I had an opportunity to play this doubling season in my hand.
Oh my goodness. That is the definition of overkill, and I love it.
Yeah.
Man, I don't have any flyers at the moment.
You also get twice the ability counters.
Yeah, I don't want to get one-shotted over here.
Do you get 4 times the +1/+1 counters because it sees the ability counters coming in as double?
Let's see. Put a 1/1 counter on Cathedral for each counter put on a creature this way. Yeah.
Oh, yes. That's so brutal. Okay, I have double flying. Because I have double flying, I get 4+1/+1 counters.
Just in case one of the flying counters gets removed somehow, you know. Can't be too careful.
Alright, I'm going to pay 3, and Cavern of Souls is going to make a white for Bastion Protector. Commander creatures I control get +2/+2 and have indestructible.
Yeah.
I love that card. I love the cycle that where they give commander creatures the bonuses. I love that same cycle. So Bruise is now a 5/5 indestructible.
I love that whole lieutenant cycle that they did back in, was it 2015 or something? 2014.
Logan, would you like to gain a bunch of life?
I would love to gain a bunch of life.
I too would also like to gain a bunch of life.
Sounds like collusion to me.
Bruce Tarl is going to attack, targeting himself, and it's going to attack you, Logan.
Sure, I will block with my 11-11 double strike.
Yep.
I found my Gonti card, by the way, Logan.
So, first strike, they boop, and then second strike, or normal strike, they boop.
Yep.
So I'll gain 22.
We booped so many times.
Oh boy.
It should be inappropriate.
So I go back to 39 from 17.
I'm really hoping that Anton has a way to reanimate that tree.
You mean like the fan?
Oh,
play?
My things can't even block. That's neat. Okay.
Uh-oh.
That was ridiculous.
I mean, this is a way to reanimate that tree.
Yeah, so. There you go. Yeah. And it has haste too, so.
That's... Shh, don't tell anyone. It might feel threatened by me.
Ooh, I'm kind of hoping for that to happen. Wait, does it have haste right now, Felden?
No, Felden.
No, Felden makes copies with haste.
Right, but you can't actually activate it now.
No, and it costs mana.
Yeah. So I'm going to make these satyrs useful, and I'm going to cast Ashnod's Altar. So here's my biggest regret, that when Tomer, the turn before Tomer casted that Deadly Tempest, I had this in my hand, and I was like, should I cast it now, just in case somebody goes for a board wipe? Yeah, big oof. All right, I'm going to pass turn.
Okay, at end step, I'm going to just cycle Desert of the Mindful and hope that I find an answer. Ooh. Wow.
I'm offended. How dare you do an action at the end of my turn?
Okay. I think that's best I can do.
Well, where's your Grand Abolisher if you don't want him to do that?
At the end of your next turn, I will just keep holding priority, Joe.
Ooh. Yeah, this is not looking great.
Do you have a way to mass bounce? I know there's a 6 CMC bounce spell that does that.
Yeah, I do not have it. I have targeted bounce, but Hexproof is making it very difficult.
Man, I wonder why he put the Karnas Tyrant in the graveyard.
I mean, you have a flyer to block, so you're not dying to it in one swoop.
If it maybe doesn't it will, because die. Jonas
can make it bigger.
Okay, let's...
I mean, it is a one-shot robot.
I can only pump once with Ronas.
You can only pump once because you only have one green?
I only have 5 mana.
Oh.
I would have
to go over this.
Top
deck
land for that.
2, 4. 2 like that. 6. Omnixilis. Unshackled.
Oh, yes.
What can we do here?
So, lay on floor, curl up in a ball, cry, roll over, cry
all,
some more.
All valid things. All valid things. I'm going to bounce your Ronas, though. I'm going to evoke Aether Snipe.
Sure.
Just to send a message.
Yeah.
So, evoking Aether Snipe. When it comes into play, return target non-land permanent to its owner's hand. And then I cry. Oh, and then I play a Mountain Valley, and then I cry. Yeah. And I pass the turn.
You do get a counter on your Nyxilis from Creature Dying.
Getting big.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Forgot about that.
Right. I intended to do that for the synergy.
Of course. Now it's a 5/5.
That was the plan.
How about top decking something that helps me not die to Logan? Come on, deck. It's not too shabby. It's not a land.
So chat is going on with the conversation about webcam games and the limiting factor of cloning and stealing other permanents. And I, for one, feel that having the infinity tokens or just blank sheets of paper around does kind of eliminate that barrier, but it's still a hard barrier to cross because just writing something down on a sheet of paper isn't always going to send the right message for everybody as far as tracking things on the board. What are y'all's opinions?
Having played webcam Magic since literally April of last year and not just the pandemic, no issues whatsoever. I was using scratch paper or we were just kind of keeping track mentally of things. The infinite tokens make them way easier to keep track of.
I'm going to start with my Milliken.
So what's going on. There are still some things like shifting board states like Aminatu or the biggest barriers are like searching somebody's library.
Yeah,
like,
that's the hardest one.
I can't play my Bolas deck because there's too many things where I steal other people's things that are not even on the battlefield.
Or even something as simple as like a Gitaxian Probe. you know, yeah. That's difficult.
So there are things like that where it's mechanic wise, but as far as like, man, putting cards on a battlefield from somebody else's board, whatever, it doesn't matter. You can just do this.
I think I'm not gonna cast anything.
What did you mill with the mulligan?
I milled a blood tracker, and I think that's a decent blocker for Kefril, so at least I'm not dying to the commander damage.
That you know of.
Make a blood tracker, pay for life, block for toughness, not die, draw two cards, sounds decent. So am I going to attack anywhere? I don't think so. Yeah, I'm going to pass.
All right.
Yeah, I can't imagine it's too bad. I mean, if everybody has a phone, they can look up the cards that you need, and then you just write down the name, and then you have the phone to get all the card text and everything whenever you need
to
look at it.
There was one card somebody attempted to cast the webcam game where we kindly asked them not to, because we didn't want to resolve a thief's auction and then having three piles of permanents on each player's board, because they all belong to different players.
Yeah, that would be excessive. Like one or two theft cards. If you're running like a theft deck, though, that just seems it will get obnoxious after a while. You could also just run it on Magic Online. That's a thing you can do. And all the cards
get out of
really
here,
well.
You purist.
I'm just saying. So there's advantages there.
This is my first webcam game.
The deck that I'm gonna play later it's Sultai clones with like Brokos or Otrimi. I can flip flop like between like six different commanders in this deck, but it's a Sultai clones deck. There's like over 20 clones in it, and it's so much more fun, I think, playing with the infinite tokens, because I can draw stuff when I clone something. Because even when you're playing face to face with a clones deck, it's like, okay, here's a clone. Oh, what was that again? Yeah, it was this thing. So it doesn't really matter whether it was like in person or over webcam. I'm able to like write down what the thing is and then put some notes on it, or you know, whether I've spark doubled something and it's legendary or not. But
and it to your point, I do know that a lot of players out in the world, they have a thing about people touching their cards. So
yeah,
when you go to steal their permanent, it's like, well, I'm just gonna set it off to the side and you can have that. And it's like, oh, okay, that's fine. That's fair.
Yep.
Hmm.
I'm going to play this Arcane Signet.
Hey, there's your mana problems.
Yeah.
All solved with one Signet.
Whole one mana. I'm going to recast Ronus.
Ruh-roh, Raggy. All right, who you killing?
Good question. I mean,
who's forced to block, right?
Yeah. I feel like I'm going to gain a lot of life regardless. I feel like I'm most afraid of Anton, because he has one of my cards.
That's a very valid
card. Could be a really good card.
Maybe I hit four lands. Who's to say?
So we're going to go to combat, and we're going to swing Cathril at Anton.
I want to do something before blocks.
Sure.
I want to reanimate this blood tracker I was talking about.
So Felden's gonna make a copy?
Just make a copy of it. It's an artifact. And if I'm good going to blocks, I would like to block your Cathril.
Yeah.
Then I want to activate it twice, losing 4 life and putting 2 counters on it.
Sure.
Because it's like a greed. Then I will take a bunch of damage from your commander.
So it's a 4/4.
Yeah. So I'm going to take 18.
Yeah, 11. It's 22 minus 4. 18, yeah. Cool. I will gain 22.
18 commander damage. Yes.
Not bad.
I will go to 61.
All right, the blood tracker dies, right?
Yeah, it does. Yeah. And I draw 2 cards because there's 2 counters on it.
Yeah, and it was just a token copy of
this
it.
It was a token entering and dying. I'm going to adjust the commander damage. I feel like I've died to commander damage from you a bunch in the games we played.
I'll be there.
Voltron, a strat you enjoy?
commander damage happens. This is like a pseudo Voltron because I can win without Cathrall in this deck. Because I mean, keyword soup creatures are really good.
Yeah, you can just reanimate everything.
So one question: do you have Audric Lunark Marshall in there? Please tell me you do.
Maybe.
No, I think they're the perfect.
I do. Yeah.
Audric is amazing.
So Audric, and then if I slam a Chroma or
we're good to move
Questing
to
Beast.
My turn, right?
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay.
A Chroma or Questing Beast with Audric, and to give Cathrall haste. I've done that before. It's really good.
Yes. Yeah. I just love that Audric in so many ways. It's a really underappreciated, underutilized commander.
Yeah, other than this, I only have one other actual Voltron deck, which is Bruna Light Alabaster.
Hmm.
That's a fun deck.
Or a Voltron.
Yeah.
So I need to gain some life.
That deck's always a meta game for me of trying to survive getting punched in the face. And then it's sort of like Aura Roulette. I don't know what I'm going to get.
I guess I'm going to Cavern of Souls for white, another white, two, and two more for Captain of the Watch.
Soldiers.
Don't you have too much life and too much board presence?
My two whopping creatures.
Who has too much too much board presence? Look at all the
creatures. Always too much board presence.
Oh man, my these two creatures.
Did you get your counter from my blocker dying, Toma?
Oh yeah. It is now 8-6-6, which is right. Still not big enough for Cathro.
Oh man.
Logan, I remember the awful Emrah Cooler head against you with my Obnixil the Snake. We're like, well, I guess I can't do anything.
Yeah. I'm like, crap. And then I'm like, wait, he literally doesn't have anything he can do.
Didn't even draw a fetch land.
So I'm going to move to combat. And Tomer, I'm going to go at you with a 5-5 double strike on indestructible lifelinker.
You know what? I'm gonna take it.
Oh, okay. Interesting. That is commander damage.
Oh, but I haven't taken commander damage yet, right?
From Bruce?
From Bruce.
You have not taken commander damage from Bruce, no.
Yeah, I will take it, because I need the blockers for Cathrall to survive a turn. So I'm gonna go down to 15, and that's 10 commander damage from Bruce.
This game will be over in.
I just hope we're at the point where I'm not the target for Logan anymore.
I mean, eventually.
If you can kill anyone with one attack, why bother doing like the overkill there, right? You don't even gain the strike life.
Trying to direct me elsewhere.
I'm pretty sure he's
coming out of the already. Just let me get in second. Come on, Logan.
Go ahead.
Do you even want to attack someone when they die to first strike damage?
Yeah.
Seems like a big
right.
I mean, I feel like everybody's had their time to shine and do their thing. Some more so than others.
Anton, can you do any damage to Logan on your turn? Can he lower his life total by any amount?
He can lower it to 13.
I mean,
I can lower it by a tiny amount, maybe.
If I lower Logan's life to 10, can you finish him off?
I currently can't deal 10.
No life loss or anything?
He'd have to have no blockers, though.
I can play something that can deal some damage later, but then people need to cast spells. I have a Kervex, so if you can cast spells that cost lots of mana on Logan's turn, then we can kill them.
I can lower his life total to 10 now, and that's it. That is the most I got.
I mean, that works, though. Every little bit helps, because he's just going to get out of control. So I still suggest that it's a stronger...
I feel like the problem is if Toma deals a ton of damage to Logan, I finish off Logan, then Joe is just going to slay both of us.
know what? What I will do is probably, you know what? I'm going to crack the mountain valley first for just a swamp. There's one.
Isn't that the one that needs to get plains, forests, or mountains?
Oh, yeah, that. It is. Yeah, I didn't mean a swamp. I meant
oh, I meant this other thing.
Forest. There you go.
Oh.
Order cards, anyway. Okay. Shuffle. And then. Okay. Then. More desperation mode activated.
I mean, there are ways in which I can deal 10 damage to Logan. If I mill an anger with my Millikin, I might be able to do things with haste.
But you still have to get around a flying. Can you get around the flyer?
So far, I can't.
Hmm. Yeah, okay. 2, 4, 6.
Logan, I hope you don't mind becoming the arch enemy.
10.
I'm used to it. Do you see the shirt that I'm wearing? I wore it for this particular event.
You know what? That'll be it for me.
And it's not like we have much choice on board.
I'll have an end of turn thing.
Oh no.
I'm afraid.
I'm gonna path to exile Felden.
Yep.
You can choose to search for another land if you want to sacrifice the creature and lose 10 life.
That's a big oof. That's the big
oof. You can't get rid of your Obnix in this
response. I kinda need a block. I need to absorb a hit.
I guess I'm not getting a land here.
I mean, you could lose 10 life.
Sounds bad.
Well, the problem is he's only got 8.
Yeah. Maybe like Angel's Grace or something off it.
I think I'm good. Felden's the threat here. Well, what can we draw?
Yeah, I wasn't much liking the get things out of my graveyard. Maybe set Logan a 13.
yeah, I can see that.
I'm gonna
add a colorless mana. Mill a Master of Cruelty. See, like, that couldn't hurt anyone.
Yeah, that would have been pretty good.
You can block it.
Just that's true.
Trade. Your commander's indestructible, so it wouldn't even trade.
Yeah.
So.
Nevertheless, I mean, that's a creature card there. It's pretty good.
So I'm gonna play on land, Naya Panorama. I have 7 mana. Can I do something useful with 7 mana? Like, I can't produce enough blockers in the air, so if Logan kills me. That's fair. So.
I don't know if he's gonna be your next target now that he's taken out the biggest threat on your board to him.
Maybe Logan's a merciful god.
Yeah, it depends what he plays.
That sure depends on what I play. I'm just gonna play the biggest pickers, I think.
Biggest pickers?
I'm gonna cast Ilark.
Ooh.
Oh, nice.
And then.
Another card that needs haste.
Yeah.
There is a recurring theme here.
Oh, sorry, I need to tap differently because I want to activate my panorama. Because I can't do anything else with 2 mana. I could play like a 3-drop that doesn't do anything. I don't have enough red mana. I have 2 red mana, so I can't play a red 3-drop. Yeah, that's bad. I'm just gonna. I can't even crack my panorama because I lose life.
Nope.
That's great. Feels amazing.
Oh, man.
I guess I'm not gonna do anything here. I'm gonna pass. This is fun.
I have stuff at end step.
Yeah,
stuff at end step.
We got end step.
So I'm gonna cycle Shefet Monitor at end step. which will let me draw a card. Well, first I'm going to get a land, and then I'm going to draw a card. I think now I'm going to get that swamp that I was hoping to illegally get with the...
Wait, did I overpay for my Illag? I tapped 4 and had 1 colorless floating and should cost 4, right?
Yeah.
So if I have 1 more mana, I can cast 1 more spell. Sorry, it doesn't do much. I just want to cast it. I'm going to cast Logan's Great Henge.
Logan's Great Henge? Signature spell?
And I'm gonna...
That is an extra spell. And you can gain life and draw.
In my head, I had enough mana to cast the Great Henge, then I cast Illag, and there was 1 mana shot, and I was like, huh, that's weird. Oh, it doesn't cost 5 mana. That makes sense.
Really hoping for some insane top deck action.
Yeah, it was a great thing I hit off of Gonti.
Draw card.
It's not insane. It doesn't do things.
Then I have a second instance that I would like to cast.
Oh.
1, 2... Doesn't really matter. 3, 4, 4. There we go. For that beautiful tapping motion. Dream Eater. I'm going to cast Dream Eater, and when it enters the battlefield, I can survey 4, and when I do, return target non-land permanent to an opponent controls to its owner's hand. I'm going to target the Rhonas, but I am going to survey. Ooh. Man.
That's a vendetta right there.
Yep, poor Rhonas. What do you have against snakes?
Well, the problem is the pump. The whole pumping action on the Cuthril is kind of scaring me a little bit.
Are you a doctor of archaeology? Perhaps is your last name Jones? Do you just have a thing with snakes?
I hate snakes. Yeah. All right. So I'm definitely going to put these two into the graveyard, and then... 1 second, I'm making a decision. Oh, wait, can't move my...
Decision to rename Logan to Seraph Snakes.
I'm deciding whether I want to keep these cards. I need to look at my decklist 1 sec. Okay, interesting. Very interesting.
On my next turn, if I don't take any damage and don't die, I have enough life because of the Great Henge that I can search my library with my lands again. Go to two.
Go to?
Yeah. Power plays.
Oh, man.
This is interesting choices.
Yeah. Imagine not playing anything useful.
I'm going to put it like that. 2 on top. And yeah, I'm going to bounce around. And I'm done. Sorry.
I'll attack.
I feel like someone's done.
Ooh. Yeah, someone's dead.
Hmm. Interesting.
If I have a 10 drop that I can put into play, like a 10 power creature with Illag, then I can deal as much damage as Logan's commander with my whole board.
Interesting.
If Umori and the Great Henge, I was a junt deck all along.
Let's go to combat. I think. Is that what I want to do? Yeah. We're going to go at Tomer.
Okay. It's 11-11 double strike trample?
Yep.
So I need to absorb at least 4 damage, or else I'm dead. And then if there's any pump, then I'm super dead.
Have that go again?
Why would green have any pump?
Tell it to the snake that's in your hand again.
Interesting. Interesting. Okay.
It would be so funny if Logan had Tainted Strike.
That'd be brutal. I'd be very sad. Okay, I'm going to... I will block with my... Hmm. I'll block with the Obnixilus, the Sphinx, so that's six toughness. And wait, no, sorry. Six and so 11 toughness. And then keep the Dream Eater?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Yeah, I'll just block with those two. So I'll block, I'll double block with Omnixus, which is 6/6, and Sphinx of Enlightenment, which is 5/5.
Okay.
So you'll be taking 11.
Yep. 11 tramples over. Or
yeah.
Hits you on second. Yeah.
That all happens, and these two die.
Hey, look, Anton, you can search your library free of charge.
I go to 83.
Oh my God.
Yay.
So I take 11, so I'm at 4. And Cathril did 11 commander damage to me.
And second main.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to cast this Beacon of Unrest and put Obnixilus on my battlefield.
Ooh.
And that will shuffle in after I draw this. I will be done after that.
Okay.
So, Joe, just letting you know, I have an answer to Logan. So, please don't kill me.
To the board or to the person? Like, the life total?
I will incidentally wipe the board, but I can get rid of Cathril.
Incidentally wipe the board.
Well, no, God, you mean it's like incidental wiping the board doesn't mean like everybody dies except
nobody
you?
Nobody dies. Nobody dies. I wish. I wish I could kill everybody right now. No, I'm just going to reset the board and get rid of Cathril in the process.
It feels like Logan's gonna get this great bench into his hands.
That's a guarantee, though, right?
That's a guarantee. I have it on top of my library. So then from there, I'm pretty sure I can deal with Cathril pretty handily. Ooh, whoa! It's really pouring outside. Wow, that changed fast. Ooh, I have to close.
Take one second bio break. I have no responses, so
yep.
We've got 30 minutes though, so it's gonna reset the board, and I'm gonna lose all my tokens and lose my advantage.
Oh man, that's boring. Whew, sorry, I'm back. I had the patio door open, and it's crazy out.
Nice.
So keep me alive, please.
That's a hard ask. That is a really hard ask.
Well, do you have an answer to Logan at all?
No, I was just going to play Kingmaker and knock you guys out, and then just, you know, he wins the game.
I'm okay with this.
That's fair enough
if you want to do that. Or if you want a shot at winning, I can give you that shot.
You're asking me to rebuild a board that's pretty substantial right now.
I mean, I'm at 4 life, Anton's at 8. I'm pretty sure you could, like, sneeze on us and we'll die.
I'm game with this whole plan. Yeah,
I mean, right?
Right?
I'm not concerned with who's winning or who's losing. I'm concerned with the time that we have because I want to make sure that everybody else gets their game. We've been doing really good on the schedule.
Yeah, it's a good impression.
True. Let Logan win.
I mean, yeah, it's not that I want to gain. Garner a favor with Logan. I just we've been playing for a good little bit, so let's go. And Anton said he had to go take care of something, so he's got 1, 2, 3 blockers. He can gain 2. These guys are 6.
I have returned.
Welcome back.
We were just discussing if I want to just make the pendulum swing all the way over to Logan and be Kingmaker and just take both of you guys out.
Looks like you can do that if you want to.
What's that?
Feels like you're dying on Logan's turn then.
Yeah, he will win the game.
He's accepting the fate.
I want to see what Toma wants to do next turn, to be honest.
Oh, I just don't want it to take another hour though.
I mean, if the bot's gonna get destroyed, you might as well.
Let's just check do this first. I'm going to Crozen Grip targeting the Great Hinge.
Oh, no.
Great. I can and make mana though, because mana is not an ability that I activate, yes. Right? Yeah, gain 2 life. Woo. Still can't pay for searches.
Right, getting so, there.
Since you are restarting the board, I might as well. Let's just go 6 satyrs and 3 2-2 soldiers and a 5-5 double striking lifelink commander at Anton.
What? Can you say that again? 6 satyrs and the life linking double strike commander, right?
And also 3 2-2 soldiers at you.
I did so much. Well.
Well.
Well then.
I'm gonna jump your commander with the ooze.
Okay.
And I'm gonna block 2 soldiers with Gonti and Ilark. And I'm gonna take 8.
Yes, you are.
Yep.
Great hand is so good. 2.
Good amount of damage.
Alright.
And then so
Anton is in sneeze range.
And then Obnixilus gains a whole bunch of.
Oh yeah. How many was that?
Tokens.
A whole bunch of awesome counters.
2 things 2 died and on used. Joe's board and 1 died on my board.
So a 1/1 satyr died and then a 1/1
the 2 of the soldiers. And blocked 2 of the soldiers and it okay. Jumped your commander. So you got okay. Like half of the lifelink from first strike damage.
Yep.
Yep, so just 3.
No, it's double strike. Oh, I see what you're saying, though.
Yeah.
That's, my ooze is dying.
Okay, so it's, so then I only gained 5 there, which is unfortunate.
You're still at 20 life total. I wish I was double digits, you know?
That feel Toma, when...
Toma, can we 2 agree on a truth?
I'm still twice the life total.
I think Joe has done a good job for Logan, so you and me, Anton, we have to stick together.
This was the least damaging, like, this is the least amount of damage I can do, okay?
Uh-huh.
I could have taken you out, Anton. I had a Captain Overwatch and a Bastion Protector to swing.
Yeah, I definitely know, and I appreciate not dying.
So, that I just want to move the game along? Also? Go ahead.
Yeah. I guess it's still better for you to let me and Thomas stay alive than kill us and try to 1v1 Logan.
It's better for me to keep y'all within lower range, too, so that way I can just swing after the reset, so...
Mm-hmm.
So, untap? Me?
Yeah, you're good. I'm gonna use the rest of it.
Logan with the sweet spike feeder die as well.
Mm-hmm. I have 2, and then for the Kickstarter, I added on 18 dice, so that I can get 10 blue and 8 green.
How many did you get?
Might have misread the card a little bit.
I think I got 10 dice from the Kickstarter.
I was like, sweet, mass bounce. This works. And then I read the other part of it. That's not good. That's not good at all. Interesting.
Not quite. Is it a flood of tears?
No.
Oh.
That would have worked, kind of.
What else would it be? 6 mana.
I mean, it's River's Rebuke, but it works against 1 person, which is fine.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's not good. Oh,
what
no.
Happened?
The other answer is right on top of my library.
He said that he misread the card.
That was an oopsie. Okay.
No, I tiptoe here. If your answer
is the creature, you could play Jeruda and put it into play, right?
Yeah, but it has... Yeah. So the answer was 1,000 Winds, and it's a mass bounce spell, but requires the creatures to be tapped.
Mm-hmm.
Kithril has Vigilance, so...
That's true.
This does not work as I intended it. I do have...
Tomer.
I do have answers.
That'll be punt count number 3 for the game.
I mean, you can cast Geruda and a 6 drop, right? So there can be some fun.
Yeah, okay, fine. We'll just cast Geruda and see how that resolves. So 2. And 4, 6. Let's cast Geruda. When it enters the battlefield, each player puts the top 4 cards of their library into their graveyard. Put a creature card with an even converted mana cost among those cards onto the battlefield under your control.
I have an Archfiend of Despair for you.
Whiff.
Wait, what? That's a good thing, right?
Archfiend of Despair?
Oh my goodness.
See, players, opponents can't gain life, and it's a wound reflection for opponents as well.
If they lose life equal to how much?
The amount of life.
Life they have lost this turn.
Oh, that actually kills him.
If you can do half his life total, then it kills him.
Okay, then put it into play.
So
you want an Archfiend of Despair?
Yes, I would like the Archfiend of Despair. Do they get exiled or no?
No, they just
stay in the graveyard.
Okay, so I'm going to get Massacre Worm from my graveyard. I'm going to get the Wound Reflection.
You only get one.
You only get one.
You get one, right?
Oh, it's one person?
You only get
each
one.
Player. Okay. Oh, yep. Okay, never mind. I'm not taking this then. I'm taking the Archfiend.
Everybody get one.
I'm dead after this, but this will be a funny way to get out of the game. So I get the Archfiend of Ifnir. Hello, Archfiend.
I forget.
And then I'm going to pay...
Are you blood tributing right now?
No.
Oh.
No, it's Sorin.
Oh, it's 100% Sorin.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, Sorin with the wound reflection is so brutal.
That worked out perfectly. That was exactly how I drew it up. Yep. So I'm going to cast Sorin, and then Sorin Markov will tick down. So he's going to go to 1 loyalty. Logan, I would like your life total to go down to 10.
Uh huh.
So you lose 73 life.
Yep.
And then I will pass, and then Archfiend works.
You could hit Joe for 8, basically, with your flyer.
But I need blockers so I don't die.
Blockers, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'm done, I think.
It was a clutch companion.
Wow, that was incredible.
So that's actually why I did it that way. I didn't actually want the 1,000 wins to work. I actually just wanted to top deck an Archfiend of Ifnir off Anton's board state, which I definitely knew was right there. So
yeah, you had it the whole time. Never didn't have it.
What is it called? Archfiend of Despair.
Despair, yeah. It's like an 8 drop, 6/6. I think I didn't have anything else you could have hit that dealt 10 damage.
That there is my hand.
Yep. Okay. Yeah, that's my end step, and I'm done.
So Anton's back in the game.
What does back mean here? I have 2 life. 2.
That's true.
I mean, don't waste it, right?
Oh man. Ever After was on top of my deck.
Nice.
Oof. Ooh, yeah.
So I was getting back probably like a Chromasaur.
Yeah, I think it'd probably take out me and Anton at the same time.
Yeah.
Like, Cathedral's very resilient. Oh, having, like, just indestructible annex group is very difficult.
That makes a difference. The soldier has vigilance because it kept on the watch. I was like, man, I don't have any blockers.
How much mana do I have? Probably not enough. Seven that can make a land drop.
So that was really awesome.
Yeah, that worked out better than my initial plan of trying to bounce everything with 1,000 wins. And then I had everybody sacrifice a creature. So I was going to bounce the Rhonas and then make everybody sacrifice. Or bounce the Obnixilus, bounce the Rhonas, bounce everything, make Cathedral be sacrificed, but then Cathedral just comes back.
Yeah.
So that'd be difficult.
Fun. I think I have some fun plans here.
That does not bode well.
Wait, how big are creatures here? Thomas creatures are huge.
So these are five. These are five fives.
So 6/6.
Ilark does put into play tapped and attacking, but I don't want to attack. I just want something in play.
I think good just kills us now, but
I mean, it might. Maybe I'm just too dumb.
I really don't want to win by default.
I have a plan here. Maybe it's
okay.
Bad.
Okay.
I'm gonna K5 mill a card, which is a Sin Prodder, and I'm gonna cast the Terror of the Peaks.
Ooh,
is that the one that's like a Warstorm Surge? Where
okay, that's a card. That is definitely
yeah.
A card.
Yeah.
And then I would like to move to combat.
Oh my gosh, this is not about.
I'm gonna swing Ilark at Joe.
Yep.
Ilark has a trigger, and I'm gonna put Baltor the Defiled into play.
Oh no!
And I'm gonna activate Baltor to return all black and red creature cards from all graveyards to their owner's play. So what? You get all your black and red creatures to play.
Okay.
Uh oh.
Get Geared.
Do you have Terror of the Peaks triggering?
Oh yes.
Oh, this kills. Gonna trigger. It's gonna kill us.
Don't forget.
I think it's gonna kill everybody.
Omnixilis is exiled since I had control of it.
Oh, okay. Yes. Exile. Black and red.
Yeah. Black and all red. So do you get all black creatures you have?
Just the Massacre Worm, I guess.
Oh, Massacre Worm?
Oh, you guys are dead.
It's gonna kill me because you have a Massacre Worm.
Yeah, the Massacre Worm's trigger is gonna go on the stack.
Oh, yes, because I'm the active player.
Yeah.
Yeah, after you pass turn, you're just both dead because the Archfiend.
Wait, but how does this?
Hang on. With the Massacre Worm trigger on this stack, I guess. Well, I'm still gonna lose. Oh my gosh.
I'm gonna die, but that's fine.
Really? Like, how does this stack work with
yeah,
that? I'm a filthy motor player, so
I'm
I don't know.
I'm the active player, so your Massacre Worm trigger is on top of my trigger, and it's gonna kill me because my small creatures are gonna die before I'm gonna shoot you with the Terror.
It's only two toughness creatures that die.
Yeah.
But
you're at two, right? Yes, the Milliken's got you.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's the flashiest thing I could do, so I wanted to do it.
Did I stumble my way to victory? Did I punt my way to victory?
No, you didn't, because your Archfiend is also going to go away at the end of. I'm still going to be alive. I'm going to lose a lot of life, but I'm still going to be alive.
Oh, you're going to kill my Archfiend?
No, it goes away as soon as Anton is.
Yeah.
Right.
You'll still lose a lot of life.
I'm going
to do any damage to Joe because all my targets are going to physically because I die before triggers.
So I'm going to lose 14, go down to 20.
Oh, you're fine.
I'm going to die because I have a few creatures dying.
Fantastic.
Mori came into play saying Planeswalker, by the way, just because I can.
Send a message.
Oh, yes.
All right. Well, that was...
Wow. So Archfiend is gone.
Yeah, so I don't lose another 14.
Suicided the Balfour so much. Just always hilarious.
All right.
I think Joe's still got it.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, there's a lot of creatures, and I don't have that many blockers.
So you have three blockers. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then plus the other rhino token that I'm about to populate. I think that'll do it.
King make there, Anton.
Imagine forgetting about that second one. I didn't have anything helpful in my hand anyway. So like I had like an Inferno Titan and a Crowax, like nothing doing anything.
I gotta say, that was the swingiest game I've played in a little bit.
It was fun.
Yeah, that was good.
I'd love to talk some more. If you guys are up for it, I'd love to talk some more.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm down.
Sure.
About the game.
Go through a little bit what else was in my deck.
Yeah. Probably should have done that before shuffling.
So that was the thing I had planned with Baltor. I had Baltor for like 3 or 4 turns, but I never had enough black mana to play him and activate him. So getting him in play with Illag to cheat some of the costs to activate him and play the Terror was a long-term plan, but the Massacre were just wrecked me.
So, I did not expect any of that. So
most of my deck is just good value creatures that have a lot of keywords. Some of the things outside of that are like Tortured Existence, a black to discard a creature card and return a creature card from hand to graveyard to hand. So I can just swap two. If I have one that I want keywords in the graveyard, I toss it in there, I get something else back.
Man. So Eerie
Ultimatum's great.
Yeah, it is. I had Druid's Deliverance for your Cathril Swing. That's all I had.
No.
It's like, okay.
Oh, blanks the damage.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
Stuff like Majestic Myriarch to get all the other abilities. There's some mini tech in here with Nethroi. Nethroi is just a good creature, but Faeborough Elder, and I also have Multani, the new Multani in here.
Oh, so good.
They're both 0 power creatures, so I can just add them to the Nethroi mutate trigger for free. Like, there's no drawback. And then still add up to 10 for the rest of it.
Oh, yeah. Ah, Tortured Existence, I love that card. Reminds me of my pauper days.
What else we got?
So I had Cathar's Crusade, Champion of Lambolt, all the other like buff and tribal synergies in here, in addition to the... So whenever I'd hit with the Wynota, I'd be able to just like stack all those and be able to just go from like a small swing to an alpha strike. Jarena is really good in this deck. But yeah, none of the big stuff came out. A bunch of the smaller stuff did.
Yeah.
I got some other stuff like Sanctum of Eternity, Panharmonicon, Conjurer's Closet to keep repeating the Cathro Blink or ETB, which is just good value. Since Cathro lets you put those counters, keyword counters on other creatures, it lets me kind of decide if I want to shift things around after an attack or whatever. Or if I put new creatures in a graveyard, I get additional stuff.
So other Wynota tech that I had was Oketra's Monument to get the white warriors for the trigger, and then Tendershoot Dryad, which Tendershoot Dryad is just really good card to have in EDH in general. I like to put that in all my green decks.
Yeah, there's a...
So this deck actually changed a lot over time. It started out as just a normal Grenzo deck with all the good stuff that you have in there, like Artifact Dram, Pathstone, and make Grenzo better, reanimate some silly stuff. But then I figured that I liked the idea of building around maximizing the value you get of Grenzo. So I played up to 6 power in my creatures to get huge things. And then I played like synergy cards that allow me to fetch up lands. So I play like the 4 Glaciers, I play like Pilgrim's Eye versions, the Land Cyclers, so I can thin my library so I have huge hits left. And then I needed to figure out a way of like, how can I do everything I need to do with creatures only? So my ramp are things like the Muir and the Hedron Crawler. I have Nehab and Rakdos as like big ramp options. Yeah. I have card draw for like Red Presence or Demon Lord Belzenlog. Play removal, like a Massacre Girl form as well. Meteor Golem to get rid of anything. And then I have lots of the like burn things in Rakdos, like Dire of the Dead, Ravager hurts anyone. Flayer of the Hatebound is great with Grenzo, like the Dragon as well. Like Haste Lords, like Urabrusk. And because I have so much fetching to Finn, I also play some landfall synergies with Obnixilis and the Nesting Dragon.
Nice.
Yeah, it's like good reach with like the tree. You have tree, and then you have all these ways to like close out the game with a little bit of extra burn.
You have some insane starts. You have like turn 2 ramp creature, turn 3 tree, turn 4 Nehab, use tree, make like 27 red mana. Things can get pretty crazy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I have no control what's on the bottom of my library, so what I have no control for grand to hits, and I don't have much card run removal, so it's very swingy and just does some fun things most games. So I like to play that deck.
I had a sub theme. I had a sub theme with Zulaport, Cutthroat, and Bastion of Remembrance, and then also I had a couple of sack outlets, as you saw with the Ashdod's Altar, to sort of get around the craziness that was Cathril.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that was my other theme, was the aristocrats kind of, because an axe would make tokens that I would be able to secondarily sack. So.
Do you have Garna in there?
I don't. I didn't put her in there. I made an active decision not to put her in here.
She can. Pretty loopy with that Ashnod's Altar stuff. Jeremy Knoll uses it quite a bit.
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
You could have the recurrent trigger on the stack and then sack her to whatever. Yep.
Hey, what was your main draw to add green to the deck?
Tutor. So yeah.
Oh, just find you a Vinoda.
Yeah. There's not a lot of really good green humans that I have. Garrod being one of them. But the tutor and the land ramp is really what I needed. And actually, there are some decent, I say that, but the champion of Lambholt and then Beastmaster, like, those are actually good green humans.
They're crazy.
So yeah, I decided to add the green in, and there was a list going around. Sorry, that's a little loud. There was a list going around that had, this is kind of like a budget slash copy of another list that has Tana, the Bloodsower, and Timna. And they still have Wynota in there. And Tana, she makes sapperlings that can help you whenever trigger your Wynota. So it's easier to have it in your command zone than it is to have it in the deck.
Yeah, I like the flexibility there. Like, a lot of Wynota lists are incredibly powerful, but they have a very linear style of play because you know they produce the exact same actions turn after turn. They want consistency. And this is like a nice riff on a Wynota deck where you kind of forego a little bit of that consistency for a lot more variety. So the games look like they're a little bit more different each time you shuffle up and play, which I like in terms of like playing multiple games over the span. Like, I like games that I like decks that have a lot of variety in how you play them each time.
Yeah.
Oh, same here. Same.
Yeah. Well,
I try to aim most of my decks like that because I hate just doing the same thing every time. If I got a deck like that, I tend to either change it into a different deck or just take it apart.
Yeah, I like gimmick decks if I play like once, and then like for Commander Clash, I love gimmick decks. It's like a one.
Like Moonfolk Tribe.
Yeah, like Moonfolk are the best tribe. How dare you?
You love gimmick decks a little too much on Clash.
Well, yeah, because you only play them once, so you play them once and then you're never playing them again. But like my physical decks, I like having variety.
Sure.
Cool. All right. Sorry about that. Joe, once again, Joe with CR Game Room. We stream on Twitch weekly. We have a weekly live stream every Wednesday where you can come and talk to us. We're just a bunch of talking heads. And then we do Commander streams once a month. And we are going to have a special guest, which we have announced last night. But yeah, reach out to us, twitch.tv/CR Game Room. Our Twitter handle is the same. I'm going to put it in the chat. But yeah, I really appreciate the time, and I love all you guys that decided to, you know, come out and do this and organize it. And I appreciate being here, and I appreciate Tomer, Anton, and Logan so much for, you know, taking the time to play games.
Absolutely.
Well, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, definitely.
So yeah, I'm Seraph6. There's my link tree to my socials and stuff. You'll find me behind the scenes in a lot of channels or playing on like Olivia's stream or Jeremy's stream quite a bit. Yeah, I don't really do a whole lot of like actual content creation myself, but feel free to support me if you want to help me support the people that I support. And also, I love Nicol Bolas, so here's all of my Bolases.
I'm jelly.
All of them.
Super jealous.
Hello again, I'm Tomer, and I write on Entergy Goldfish, so you can check that site out for more of me. That's about it. What about you, Bolas? Anton?
Well, I'm Anton. I'm All Hail Bolas everywhere on Discord, Twitter, Twitch. I'm active on Twitter, and besides that, I've written some content. I've written a blog on Commander's Social Aspect. It's linked in my Twitter bio, but I will also link it here. And I also got the opportunity to write an article for the Rules Committee homepage on power dynamics in Commander, so feel free to check that out. And I play lots of webcam magic, so if you want to need people to play with, you can hit me up. But like, I'm 7 to 9 hours ahead of American time zones, so that can make things difficult. But it's always a pleasure to join fine folks like here and play with them. So I can highly recommend.
All right, awesome.
Yeah, thank you so much. I seriously appreciate you all coming out and playing some Commander on the stream today. It's really great to have you out here. And, you know, that game was crazy. So it was really, you know, something to behold. And it'll be on YouTube as a replay for anyone who's just tuning in now for the next section that's coming up.
Thanks so much.
Great. Thanks for having me.
Yep. Thanks for the invitation.
Yeah.
I'll be back for game 2 in a bit.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. There'll be a little bit of a break between now and then. We're doing the creator roundtable right here now with the creator reunion crew, as well as then after that is a gameplay with Budget Commander, as well as Logan returning for that with Benny Smith and Davey. So that should be a lot of fun coming up after that. More paper gameplay.
Hope you like clones, because that's what I'm playing in the next game.